Welcome to South Campus Theater. This is the sound of an electronic device. This is the sound of cellophane unwrapping. Please take the necessary steps to see that those sounds are not repeated during the performance. Thank you, and enjoy the show.
Oh, sorry. I get kind of involved sometimes. I guess I should introduce myself. I am Disorder. Hey, it's not that stupid. Kanye and Kim named their kid North. Okay, actually, my real name is Chloe, but sometimes it just feels like it's Disorder. People can't seem to mention Chloe without mentioning Disorder. Disorder, Chloe, Chloe, Disorder. Okay, you look confused. Would someone mind helping me read this? I'd do it myself, but I have a disorder, so we'd be here a while. Just read definition number one, if you don't mind.
A confused or messy state, a lack of order or organization.
A confused or messy state. That applies. I'll go along with that. See, I'm an artist, so I love confusion and mess. I thrive on it. Can you read the second one?
A physical or mental condition that is not normal.
What was that last word?
Normal.
Normal. Thanks for the help. And great reading, by the way. Very normal. No confused or messy state there. Every letter, right where it's supposed to be. Perfectly normal.
We post pictures of Eddie on our social media. A ton. Every day. I'm sure it's annoying for everyone else to see him constantly popping up in their feed, but we can't help it. See, pictures freeze time. And for that instant, there's no flapping or acting out, no chewing weird things or making silly faces or noises. There's just Eddie, and he looks like everyone else's kid, you know? Normal.
I'm kind of ashamed to admit this, but before I introduce my band to anyone new, I always play them his music first. I'm sorry, I just can't bear the thought of anyone saying, "Wow, that weird kid that sits by himself and never talks to anyone sure makes some amazing music." I'd rather they said, "Why does that talented kid that makes such amazing music always sit by himself and never talk to anyone?" It's silly, I know, but it makes him sound more, you know, normal.
See? That's what my mother would like me to be called. She'd like a change from disorder to normal.
Good morning, Chloe.
Hey, Mom. So instead of having to whisper...
That's my daughter. She has a disorder.
My mother could yell.
That's my daughter. She's normal!
Just look at that smile. That's a big deal for her. For everyone. It's like a race. A big race to see who can be the most normal.
Basketball, cheer!
scrub, brush your teeth. Hey, look here, put those on. Eyes up here, time to go to school. Shut her down, now let's go off your music stool. I'm really tired, just like you're never listening, and I'm losing my shit. No, that's really interesting. Come on, boy, I am begging you.
Okay, Dad.
Oh, thank God. Yahoo!
Another day in high school. Fitting in, not sticking out. Look at that kid always wearing those headphones. My friend says he's slow, he's just one of the unknowns. He doesn't have a place. You can see it all on his face. And he'll never keep the pace. Another day in.
Right arm in, left arm in, up goes the head.
High school. Breathe.
You can do this, just a flutter in your stomach.
Breathe.
There's no hurry, you'll get past this, you can make it.
Breathe.
You can't breathe, you can't understand your homework.
Breathe.
Everybody thinks you're bitchy and a problem.
Breathe.
When we break the sentence down.
Breathe.
We find the subject verb.
Breathe.
What's the preposition in the sentence?
Breathe.
Chloe.
Stupid! Who cares? Whatever.
Another day in high school. Fitting in, not sticking out. Riding the waves on the edge of disaster. Rising up the slope, going down is faster. Make sure I have my space. It's a crazy, desperate place. And with my fears, I've got to face.
He'll be fine.
Kids change.
They develop differently.
At different rates.
There is no such thing as normal.
She's just different.
He's unique.
He's special and funny. My goodness, what a sense of humor my Eddie has.
You should see Chloe's paintings. So amazing and so vivid.
And my Ben. If you asked him to write a symphony by supper, he'd have it finished by lunch. What a great composer he could be.
What a brilliant artist she could be.
What a fabulous comedian he could be.
If she could only,
if he could only,
connect,
focus,
talk,
if he could only,
if she could only,
if we could only bridge the distance.
Ben likes his room, never wants to leave it. All day with his headphones on his ears and his hands on his keyboard, I have to remind him to go to the bathroom. I'm a musician as well, so I understand. Ben's a good kid, never complains. Sits at his keyboard playing endless refrains. Lost in his music, his fingers glide on the keys. I watch him in wonder, but he never sees. It's a lonely duet, just him and me. I thought being a parent would be an exhilarating experience. Well, it is, kind of.
If I could only bridge the distance.
Chloe was 6 before I could admit something was not quite right. She was falling behind. She had trouble putting letters and numbers in order, sequencing, the therapist called it. And once she fell behind developmentally, falling behind socially was only a matter of time. So math and English were a nightmare, but art class was another story.
Chloe's artwork, it's so unique. Look how her painting's finding new way to speak. Throwing out order, she turns it all upside down. Her colors in chaos, they always astound. Kids can't see what I see, they don't know how.
You know, kids, if there's something to post,
run at, they'll poke. Chloe isn't stupid. She's a genius, just a different kind of genius.
If I could only bridge the distance.
Eddie was just fine, talking, interacting. At 10 months, he had 4 or 5 words.
In command of those words. He wasn't just parroting, he used them in context, well ahead of the curve.
So naturally, we figured Eddie was destined for great things.
A doctor, a lawyer,
a TV weatherman, it was
anyone's guess. He could be anything, and that's because
all signs pointed to success.
But then, over time, there was less.
Hard to explain it, just less.
Every day, just less.
Less talking, less interacting. By the time it was 1.5 years, there was less than less.
There was nothing, and that's what it's been for 14 years. Nothing. And you find yourself wondering about the future. What will happen when we're gone? Who will take care of him?
Who would hire her?
Who will love him?
So you pull yourself together, you drag yourself out of your delusion.
That state were in a span of 30 seconds. You go from she's perfectly normal to she's Rosemary's baby.
And you admit that there's a problem, and you tackle it.
Yes, they're different. Yes, there's a problem. It was hard to admit, but you plan your attack. So you set a course to find answers and solutions. But good luck getting anyone to call you back. All too quick you realize there's lots of lows and not enough highs. It's a house of cards on a windy day, but you hold your ground to find a way for your child. You'd do anything for that child. Persistence to bridge the distance, always facing resistance. As you try to bridge the distance to find the normal, whatever that is. Bridge the distance for a cure.
Is that so important? A cure? Do we really need cured?
People seem to think so. Uh-huh.
Welcome to Achieve Therapy, now serving number 17.
I'm not unhappy, are you? That's all I get from my mother. What's wrong, Chloe? Why so sullen? Having a bad day? I have my art and that's enough.
I have my music. Uh-huh.
Now serving number 55.
So my grades aren't the best. You don't need to be on the honor roll to make art and music, right?
Uh-huh.
So I don't have many friends. Friends will eventually let you down, just like fathers.
You don't have a father? Uh-huh.
No, I have a father.
I don't have a mother. Uh-huh.
Now serving number 119.
My father is small and square, like a check. Matter of fact, he is a check. I see him once a month when he stops by our mailbox.
I don't have a mother. Uh-huh. Not even a picture of a mother.
At some point, you had to have a mother.
I had one before I was born. For one night. Uh-huh.
One night stand. Do tell.
My dad was a roadie. Uh-huh. They hooked up at a band party and then, whoops. Uh-huh. I was told she didn't mind having me, though. She'd hang around for that. She'd experience that. Uh-huh.
Pregnant! That's so cool. I mean, childbirth, what a rush. All that pushing and breathing. That's really intense.
But I'm not really in it for the whole completion thing, so I'm probably not going to stick around for a long time. See, I prefer to accumulate experiences and just let them dangle, twisting and twerking through the vacuum of time. Is she serious with that?
Uh-huh.
So she didn't help raise you?
Nope. Uh-huh.
That sucks. At least we get money.
More money would be nice, but things could be a lot worse. Uh-huh. I think his name is Freddy. Uh-huh.
Eddie. I heard his parents talking.
He's got parents? Plural. As in two of them? Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Wonder how that works.
Now serving number 148.
Hi, Eddie.
Hey, Eddie. People say I'm quiet. Uh-huh.
I don't think he can talk. I think he's nonverbal.
Fist bump, Ed.
The universal language. What do you think he thinks while he does that? Twirls that towel?
Probably nothing much. Uh-huh. He looks calm.
What do you think about when you're writing music?
Architecture. Uh-huh.
That's cool. I think about lines and colors mostly.
Now serving whoever's left.
Hi, Eddie, right? It's nice to meet you. Ed? Eddie, can you say hi? We'll start with that. That's an easy one. Hi, Ed. Hi, Eddie. Now, I'd like to say I've heard a lot about you, but the last therapist didn't leave any notes. Nothing, not a word, zilch. Like he knew he wouldn't be back.
Hey, Ed, sorry to break this to you, buddy, but this will be our last session together. I found a new job, something a little less strenuous than trying to get you to nod yes. I'm gonna lug furniture for a moving company. Fist bump.
Ed, what would you like to do for the next 57 minutes? How about simple identification? Which is the square? Point to the picture of the square. No, that's a circle. You have to look, Eddie. You can't point to the square if you don't look at the pictures. Eddie,
nice to meet you. Ben, could you take the headphones off?
Thank you. Now, in the notes left by your last therapist, it says, let me see what it says. It says you like music.
I compose music. Uh-huh. Everyone likes music.
Is that what you're listening to now? Your music? Would you like to talk about that? Your music? Ben, can you look at me? Ben?
Hello, Chloe. I'm Mr. Bradley, but you can call me Brad if you want.
Why aren't you female?
Oh. Sorry, you'll have to take that up with my chromosomes. anyways, I'd like to keep these sessions informal, if that's all right with you. I find that works best. Now, the last therapist left some notes that say, among other things, what you like to draw. Oh, isn't that nice?
And paint, and sculpt. I'm an artist, an actual artist.
Okay. Is there anything other than this artist thing? What do you like to do in your spare time?
Draw and paint and sculpt.
That's it? What about your social life? Oh, do you have a boyfriend?
Hey, Chloe, it's me. I got to get the tickets to the Sarah Bareilles concert. My parents are going away for the weekend, so we can have another sleepover. Call me.
No boyfriend.
Send.
Tell me, I'm not like them, I'm a misfit, loser, outcast, stupid idiot.
On the outside of the outside, I'm a distant planet, far beyond the Milky Way. I'm not part of the party, I'm not part of the in crowd, I'm not part of what they all want. I'm not part of the dances, I'm not part of romances, I'm not part of anything, cause I'm not anything like you. Don't you?
amazing creatures. Marvel at the strange art of the girl who reads backwards and eats her lunch in the art room. Be astounded by this boy's complex musical compositions, yet he can't even look you in the eye. And finally, bear witness to the tale of the boy who speaks no words, unable to communicate. What does he want? What does he think? What's the difference? We're never gonna know anyway.
Can't you see why? I am better in my own world. I don't need you. I don't need a thing. Music, artwork, and whatever he is doing, saying, can't you all just let us be? You're not part of the party. You're not part of the in crowd. You're not part of what we all hold true.
Therapy.
Okay.
What did you talk about?
Stuff.
What kind of stuff?
The usual. I need to finish this, Dad.
What's the usual?
What it's like at home.
Haven't gone through that before?
New therapist.
Again? What happened to the last one? You were finally making progress.
Quit. Better job. Benefits.
This is pointless.
Ben,
do you want to go get ice cream? Ben, ice cream. Rocky Road. Okay. More for me.
How was therapy today, son? That new therapist, she's a cutie, huh? You're not going to tell your mother I said that. Fist bump. You hungry? Thirsty? How about a treat? Want to go for a walk? Have a nice long drive, and then we'll go get a treat. Swimming? We could go swimming. Or not. How about skydiving? We could go skydiving, or scuba diving, or bar hopping, we could rob a bank.
Hey, buddy. Did you feed him?
Chicken nuggets.
Again? Did you put him on the potty?
You know he won't go for me.
Hey, buddy, how's therapy? Why don't you tell Mommy all about it? Make the lunches, fold the clothes, all the things a mother does, nobody knows. Keeping schedules and cleaning the house, trying very hard to be a dutiful spouse. Cooking meals and dealing with strife, that's the daily duty of mother and wife.
Hey, Chloe, how was therapy?
Chloe,
huh?
How was therapy?
Okay.
Did you read?
Yeah.
What'd you read?
I don't know, the one about that girl.
What girl?
You know, that girl Judy something.
Oh, let me guess, Judy Moody?
Ha ha.
What'd you guys talk about?
Stuff.
What kind of stuff? Chloe, what kind of stuff?
The usual.
How am I supposed to know what the usual is? I'm not even in the room.
What it's like at home.
Again? You haven't gone through that before?
New therapist.
Another one? But you were making such progress. What happened to the last one?
Pregnant. Can I paint now?
Come on. Take the headphones off, Ben. Come on. Let's go out. Let's go to the ball game. You need to get out. Get some sun.
I'm working on something.
What is it? What are you working on?
A Fantasia.
That's great, son. That's much better than a bop. Can I hear it? That's amazing. But distractions are good too, to get away from work and recharge your batteries. The ball game does it for me, and I already made the PB&J.
Ask someone from work. Uh-huh.
You can't enjoy a ball game with the people you're trying to get away from.
Maybe you need a girlfriend. Uh-huh.
That's not easy, Ben. It's hard to meet people to find someone with the same interests.
Then there's me. Uh-huh.
Ben.
They get one good look at me and they're gone. Uh-huh. No one wants to raise someone else's kid, especially one like me.
Ben, that's not true. What about the drummer? The drummer talked to you a lot.
Yeah, about my music. Uh-huh. She's just like all the others. She thought it through and then disappeared. Uh-huh.
That's not true.
Where is she then? Uh-huh.
Who knows? On tour, probably, but these are the single people that I meet, son. Married women are crazy musicians. Take the headphones off, Ben! I swear to God, I'll take that keyboard away, Ben! 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 Give me a break, son! I got nothing here, nothing but work! You won't spend time with me because you're always with your music, and I can't find anyone else to spend time with because...
Because of me? Uh-huh.
No, that's not what I was going to say.
Then what?
Ben, can you hear me? Ben, can you see me? Locked in your music like Tommy and Pinball. I just want the key to set you free for everyone to see your brilliance. Love your music and you, sweet boy.
Make the lunches and fold the clothes, all the things a mother does, nobody knows. Keeping schedules. Eddie, not so hard. You're hurting me. Eddie!
Hey, honey. How was your day?
Take a guess.
I'll go cut the grass.
Cleaning the house. Trying very hard to be a dutiful spouse. Cooking meals and dealing with strife. I hate my life. Let's go get you changed.
Chloe, I thought we might go shopping.
New brushes. My old brushes are dying, Mom. They suck. They had these new
ones. I was thinking dresses.
Dresses?
The formal is coming up.
I don't have a date.
Maybe if you dress nice and combed your hair.
I am painting.
Your grades came today.
I am painting.
It's not your art grade I'm worried about.
Do we have to talk about this now?
Yes. You have to start paying more attention in school.
It's
we
hard.
We can't keep moving all over the country, changing schools, hoping that will solve the
it's
problem.
It's hard.
I know. It's hard.
No, you don't. You think you do, but you don't. Trust me.
Everybody has to read. You're in high school and you can barely read.
I can read.
Barely? I'm tired of having to go to restaurants with pictures on the menu.
I can't believe you went there. I can't believe you said that. I am sick and tired of hearing you nag about what you think I should be doing.
I am sick and tired of watching you sob locked up inside your bedroom.
You don't understand.
You don't understand.
You don't understand.
Try me.
You just want to have a perfect daughter.
I just want to see you try for once. Fix your hair. Show you care.
I care.
About what?
If you don't know, then never mind.
Oh, there you go. Turn your back. You don't understand. You only care about yourself.
It's not real what she wants. Just not realistic. Pretty face, pretty hair, plastic smile. Now that's the picture that she wants me to show the world. This fake perfection, it's not a true reflection of me. See me through my life.
sappy, but I add them last. 'Cause they make me happy. They're my finishing touch to a story I've told in a world I've escaped to where I have control. Each painting tells a story.
The first I heard of this normalcy stuff was in the therapist's office, the waiting room, that place where the latest cures are discussed.
Did you see this? They say it might be environmental, that it might be caused from chemical toxins in the air.
Ah, that's great. That means we just have to move the paint cans to the shed and make sure we never take him to hardware stores, grocery stores, schools, churches, swimming pools, friends' houses, or any place that might have chemicals.
Cured!
You kind of feel bad for the new ones. The noobs. The ones who haven't been on the roller coaster yet.
Ugh, the roller coaster. Or as I refer to it, here, try this. Probiotics, antibiotics.
Clean room, hyperbaric oxygen chamber.
Heavy metal detoxification. Being a musician, Ben was all over that one. Let's do the heavy metal one, Dad. He thought it would be cool.
It wasn't. Uh-huh.
And of course, the diets. Gluten-free, casein-free.
Soy-free. Believe me, none of them are free. How come it costs more money to take something out than it does to leave it in?
And none of them worked. I was waiting for some therapist to suggest that we try human sacrifice or dancing naked around a fire. When I first heard about normalcy.
You never know when one of those days is going to arrive. Those days that can change your life.
A numerical drug was about to be tested.
You hear these things so often, you tend not to pay them much mind. The latest scientific paper or newest fad isn't enough.
We've still got 14 cases of fish oil gummy bears in our garage.
So you need to see it work. You need to see the before shot and the after shot before you go all in. Again.
Our revolutionary new drug, Normalcy, is designed to attack neurological disorders at the molecular level, working to regenerate faulty brain connections. A bringing together of all those compromised to a central, normal point.
And then I saw it, the aftershot.
The same place we found out about autism, a 60 Minutes report.
In the story, they showed a boy before normalcy and after normalcy.
And the difference was?
Life-changing. And it makes you wonder, if it can do that to a kid with severe symptoms, what it might do for my Chloe, who just has a little synchronizing problem.
Or my Ben, who just has a little socializing problem.
So you look into it.
After the enormous success of initial testing, our parent company has moved to authorize additional trials of normalcy. These advanced stage 2 trials are geared to test 3 distinct manifestations of neurological disruption.
Dyslexia, Asperger's syndrome, and severe nonverbal autism.
Brain scans will record patterns of brain activity, which will then be compared to similar profiles taken throughout the testing period.
This, done in conjunction with testing,
and close one-on-one contact with the subjects,
will provide the vital data which should confirm our research.
But what do they do, the kids?
The subjects ingest the normalcy medicament.
They take a pill.
Simple. Painless.
The rest is just testing and observing.
Is there any other way than a pill? Maybe a liquid? You see, Artie doesn't take pills, so we have to grind them up in a bowl.
Honey, it's okay. If we have to, we'll give it to him rectally.
Whoa, another job for you.
That won't be necessary. Our staff will administer the normalcy dosage for the length of the trial period.
So, let's get to the paperwork. It is extensive. Medical histories, releases, etc.
Hey there. Yo!
Yes?
What's with the name? Why is it called Normal C?
I assume you're referring to the uncharacteristic spelling, the traditional ending Y being replaced by a dash, followed by an uppercase C. We have the marketing department.
Not the spelling, the meaning. Why is it called Normal C?
Excellent question, Subject 176.
Hey, I'm not a subject, I'm a Chloe.
Subjects is a standard clinical term, a convenient way of identifying the...
You can't tell us apart. We're all pretty different. The antisocial one is Ben, the one that flaps and makes weird noises is Eddie, and I'm Chloe, the pain in the ass.
Certainly I can tell you apart.
Because I would think that telling us apart would be pretty important if you're going to cure us.
And when we cure you, telling you apart will cease to be important.
I get it. The C stands for conformity.
Now if you will follow me into the...
Wait! What about my question?
Oh, yes, and your question was 176.
Chloe! How did it come by its name, this miracle drug?
We could reference it by its original designation, N55469-C, instead of normal C.
Doesn't matter. To me, it's C. Lamorne.
C. Lamorne?
I'm dyslexic, remember?
You know, I've often thought that those afflicted with dyslexia would be excellent at creating anagrams. Just write a word down and it comes out jumbled up.
Maybe I'll look into anagrams that the art thing doesn't work out.
The now, art thing?
I'm an artist. That's not in your notes?
No, there's no room for it on the chart.
Wait, so the chart doesn't have anything about who we are, what we do?
That information is irrelevant to our task.
Irrelevant? What I do is not irrelevant. Now I really need to know why it's called normalcy.
Well, it's rather complicated. The drug is designed...
Here, I got this from a dictionary. I'd read it to you, but it would take twice as long and come out sideways.
It's rather unusual for a subject to have a sense of humor regarding their disorder.
It's called a defense mechanism. If you'd gone through middle school with a disorder, you'd understand.
My name's Chloe. My word's cat. T-A-K, cat.
T-A-C, you idiot.
Really?
I'm well aware of the pitfalls of middle school life. Is that where you learned vandalism? To tear pages from books? What happens when someone needs to reference something from this volume?
When's the last time you looked something up in a book?
Normalcy. Noun. The condition of being normal, the state of being usual, typical, or expected.
What you just read.
Yes?
I don't want to be that.
In the case of Eddie Smith.
Subject 174.
Yes, the patterns are quite obvious.
You don't have to tell me more. I observed his deep obsession of wanting oral stimulation using random objects placed
in his mouth.
We will aim to break this habit, show him mouths are made for speaking. Our path is clear.
Ready!
Subject 174.
Stick to the subject, no need to learn our names. The data tells us everything, the patterns are the same. Stick to the subject, avoid our personal quirks. It's our brains that we're concerned with, let the science do the work.
Eddie, why don't you give me the object and let's play a game? Would you like that? Yes?
And, of course, the complete lack of discernible speech.
Eddie, let's look at some pictures.
What about the science?
The brain scan revealed that the initial wave is present, allowing the identification of an image.
Which of these pictures is the horse? Very good, Eddie.
It's the absence of a secondary wave which is the issue.
Now, what other pictures remind you of the horse?
In a normal brain, a picture of a horse would trigger a follow-up wave bringing images of a stable, saddle, pasture, etc.
Recommended procedure.
500 milligrams of normal C daily, then simple images leading to secondary associations and the formation of discernible speech.
In the case of Ben McVeigh.
Subject 175.
Yes, his Asperger's, his textbook case.
But with normal C, he'll thrive. All his awkward interactions, marked by verbal repetition of his inner thoughts, will cease. Mark my words.
Uh-huh.
In the absence of variety, in choices that are taken, will disappear.
For Benji!
Subject 175.
Stick to the subject, no need to learn our names. The data tells us everything, the patterns are the same. Stick to the subject, avoid our personal quirks. It's our brains that you're concerned with, let the science do the work.
Ben, I'm taking lunch orders. Benjamin, what would you like for lunch and dinner?
PB&J, uh-huh.
But you had a peanut butter and jelly sandwich for breakfast.
Uh-huh.
It's obvious that the peanut butter and jelly sandwich gives him comfort. Order it, please.
Of course.
But the most notable symptom is the overwhelming...
The overwhelming focus on a particular field, yes.
In his case, music.
Have you heard his music? Incredible. Ben, can we hear your music? Never had a lesson. Savant-like.
Stop that, please.
Thank you, Ben.
Is his gift genetic? The profile says that his father is a musician.
I would describe that influence as negligible.
How can you be certain?
I've heard his father's music.
Hi, my name is Jerry. I'm Ben's father. I'm a musician too. I wrote this. Are you dating anyone at the moment? Is that a no?
Focus on the science, please.
The ability of the Asperger to screen out distractions is fundamental to creativity.
His affliction is his salvation.
Spending your waking hours composing music into headphones is hardly salvation.
500 milligrams of normalcy daily, then.
Well, then gradually vary his dietary options and opportunities for social interactions until his obsessive behavior comes secondary to a desire to interact socially.
Finally, there's Chloe Angelina.
76.
She's quite creative, loves to paint and draw.
Not important.
But her difficulty in sequencing, her numbers and her letters, shows double deficit dyslexia.
Aha!
Dyslexia, brought about by aberrant neuronal migration.
Genetics.
Wait, so this was passed down? I have my parents to thank.
Your mother claimed your father was also afflicted, often confusing his left from his right.
We refer to this as directional dyslexia.
Directional? I don't know about that. When he heard my diagnosis, he shouldn't have any trouble finding his way out the door and out of the picture.
Hey, Chloe. Sorry about that last check. Must have been a screw-up at the bank. I'll look into it after we get back from Hawaii.
Look, Daddy. Just got my report card. Straight A's.
That's great, sweetie. Oh, and Chloe, good luck with that reading thing. Aloha.
Aloha.
I'm gonna listen to some of Ben's music and sketch.
It's wrong to lump Chloe with the other subjects.
How so?
Ben and Eddie's reward system has been altered by their condition. Chloe's has not. So failed academics and abandoning by a parent bring about shame and alienation.
Speculative.
Her issues don't lie in jumbled numbers and letters. Her issues are the result of jumbled numbers and letters. We cannot treat her case the same.
Miss Athene, I've decided we will bring your unique insights to the procedures outlined for Subject 174.
But you were scheduled to work with Eddie.
I will be working with Subject 176.
Chloe? But the staff agreed that she would benefit from a female's understanding.
I am quite capable of providing the required understanding. 500 milligrams daily and...
500?
And written and oral testing assignments increasing in complexity throughout the testing period.
Excellent. This breakthrough in treatment will bring all those compromised to a central, manageable point and a coherent, tranquil existence.
Stick to the subject, no need to learn our names. The data tells us everything, the patterns are the same. Stick to the subject, avoid our personal quirks. It's our brains that you're concerned with, let the science do the work.
Eddie, which of these pictures is the horse? Eddie, can you please show me the picture of the horse? Eddie, which is the picture
horse.
Of the... What was that? Could you repeat that? Oh, come on, Eddie, I know what I heard. I heard you
horse.
Say... Again! You said it again! Come on, if you said it once, you can say
horse.
It! Again! You said horse, you can talk! Eddie, you can talk!
Ben, can you move your headphones? what would you like for lunch?
PB&J. Uh-huh.
You had PB&J for breakfast.
PB&J. Uh-huh.
All right, on PB&J it is.
And a pickle.
Excuse me?
Could I have a pickle too?
Huh. One PB&J on the way, with a pickle.
Hateful day when I received life, I exclaimed in agony. Accursed creator, why did you form a monster so
hideous?
Hideous, that even you turned from me in disgust.
Medical
God
conferences.
In pity,
you're also convinced
made
that therapy
man
is the answer.
Beautiful and
therapy.
Alluring after his own image. But I am a filthy type of yours, more horrid even from the very resemblance.
That passage, it sounds familiar.
Shh. Look.
Reading.
Hush.
Reading.
Hush.
Reading.
Hush.
Reading.
Hush.
Reading.
Hush.
Eddie, we need to review. This picture, what is it of?
Horse.
Yes, we know it's a horse. Now it's time to move on, please. We want to have a progression, a conversation. So tell me about the place the horse lives in. What is it called? No! Pictures, you need to do this on your own. The horse is in a big place. It starts with an S. A
stable.
Yes, the horse is in a stable. Now, where is the stable? It's a big place. With fences and other animals,
farm.
Yes, the horse is in a stable,
farm.
And the stable is on a farm.
Stable.
Now let's.
Pigs.
Was that pigs?
Pigs.
We have pigs. Yes, pigs. Keep going.
Bathroom.
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 That's great, Eddie. Another really useful word, but that's not a relatable image.
Bathroom.
Oh, so you're changing the subject. That's perfectly normal.
Bathroom.
People do it all the time.
Bathroom.
I did it just this morning when my boyfriend asked me to move in with.
Bathroom.
Oh, you should see that bathroom. There is no way I'm moving in there.
Bathroom.
So you want me to take you to the bathroom?
Bathroom.
Is that what you're telling me? Yes?
Yes.
Oh my God, you just said yes!
Yes!
A purely verbal response!
Bathroom.
Your needs changed, so you changed the subject!
Bathroom.
Yes, I'll take you to the bathroom!
Yes!
Day 42, definite presence of a secondary
bathroom.
Wave connecting images! The building blocks of conversation!
Ben, I brought your lunch, PB&J
no.
And a pickle.
No!
You're not hungry?
Yes! Yes! God.
I'll just set it over here. The first two movements of your fantasia are beautiful. Just beautiful. I played them for Molly in IT and she wept.
It's so beautiful!
I mean, really wept.
Oh my God! I can't stand it!
All of her keyboard shorted it out.
Shit!
It's amazing how you can hear that all in your head, the way the melody just...
Is there a Taco Bell around here?
Not one that serves PB&J.
Funny. No. No! Creeper!
Cool. Huh?
Blew up my house.
We can run out and get you some Taco Bell if you'd like.
I'd like to go to Taco Bell and have a beef burrito.
It'll be crowded. Lots of people.
Cool.
Huh. Tape 42. Roid pathway widening. Seeking social interaction. The PB&J has been officially replaced by the burrito. And there's a possible diminishing of the vocal tick.
Uh-huh.
Good morning, Chloe.
Hey.
Are you ready to do some reading?
Too late, I finished.
But you were just getting to the good part. I'd really like to know how it ends.
You really think you're clever, trying to trick me into reading. Fine. For a moment, my soul was elevated from its debasing and miserable fears. For an instant, I dared to shake off my chain and look around me with a free and lofty spirit.
That's amazing, Chloe.
Yes, accuracy is outstanding. Now the comprehension.
What's it about? What's the author trying to say?
It's about getting up. The chains are the crap of life. It's about pulling yourself up out of the crap. You know, disorders and deadbeat dads.
That's not exactly how I would put it, but you're not wrong.
We're out of rye bread. How am I supposed to have my ham and cheese on rye without rye?
Shh.
But the iron had eaten into my flesh, and I sank again, trembling and hopeless into my miserable self.
Curious passage, but well read.
Yes, I can read. Your little pill works. You can all relax now.
Outstanding.
Day 42. Dyslexia no longer acute. Speed, accuracy, and comprehension exceeding expectations.
You should be happy, Chloe.
Really?
Why don't you take the rest of the session off? Do some sketching. You've earned it. What have you been working on?
Nothing.
Chloe's reading wonderful news. Shelves full of books and there's so many to choose. Her sketchbook lies empty. It's really left me confused. I'm worried her talent is something she'll lose. But her reading is great. She's lost her muse.
How are you today, Eddie?
I feel fine.
I like that shirt.
Thank you.
I thought we would have hot dogs for lunch today.
And chips.
Yes, you can have potato chips with your hot dog.
And Dew.
I like Mountain Dew too. I was gonna have you start our conversation today, but it seems you already have. Day 63, conversation!
A doctor, a lawyer,
a TV weatherman, now it's anyone's guess.
He can be anything, and that's because
all signs point him towards success. You know he's been needing me less, the way that I soothed him just less. Every day just less.
Ben's a good kid, hasn't complained. Sits on his cell phone playing video games. He's eating some new things, but music's strangely gone cold. It's like he's lost interest, put music on hold. He's just finding new things, that's what I'm told.
Hey Ben, what are you working on, Moomit 3?
Who was that girl in your office? The one you were talking to yesterday.
What did she look like?
She was my age, backpack and a skirt.
Oh, that must have been my daughter, Ellie.
Baby, 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 oh, like baby, baby,
Ben?
Baby, no, like baby,
Ben?
Baby, baby, oh,
Ben?
I thought you'd always be mine,
Ben!
Mine.
You've made some excellent progress here, not only socially, but dietarily. Oh, if that's even a word. And we're extremely pleased that your vocal tic has disappeared.
Uh-huh. I'm just messing with you.
How's the Fantasia coming?
Does she like burritos?
Who, my daughter?
Uh-huh. I'm sorry, I'll stop.
Thank you. She's vegan, so no beef burritos, just lots of vegetables.
Just vegetables? Boy, that's unfortunate.
She really likes music. If you finished your fantasia, you could play it for her.
Does she like artichokes? I think I could choke down an artichoke. You get it?
Ben, is it almost done, your fantasia?
I finished it.
Oh, that's great. Can I hear it?
It's not finished. Will she be coming back to visit?
That depends. Ben, can I please hear your fantasia? Ben? That's just the same note over and over. Ben? Ben?
Hey, Chloe.
Hey.
Here, I brought something for you.
Oh, no thanks. The last thing I feel like doing today is reading.
It's the Bible. All the information from the study. Procedures, notes, it's all there.
Thanks.
I think you'll find what you're looking for on page 3.
I knew it! I knew it!
It's nice to see you read that on your own. That's not...
Assimilate?
Conform. That's not exactly a third grade reader. Here, you didn't show up for your dose today. I brought it for you.
I hope you guys are putting a warning label on these things. You know, like in the commercials. Could cause depression, dizziness, drowsiness, and a complete loss of everything you are.
There are side effects to
everything. And if your loss of talent lasts more than 4 hours, tough shit.
Good morning, 176.
Help me here. What do I do?
I can't help you, Chloe. They're your consequences.
I don't see your sketchbook. Have you misplaced it?
I was wondering about something in here.
I'm late for my 11 o'clock.
Here, on page 3. This breakthrough in treatment will bring all those compromised to a central, manageable point in a coherent, tranquil existence.
Excellent reading. Outstanding progress for day
63. What does this mean? A coherent, tranquil existence?
Normalcy. Don't you want to be normal?
Not if it means I've got to be tranquil.
We're not performing lobotomies. The use of the word tranquil simply refers to a state free from the anxiety of your diagnosis.
So normal means tranquil.
Your reading and comprehension have rapidly increased. I would think you would feel satisfaction, perhaps even gratitude.
I might, except now my drawing sucks.
Yes, but you can finally maintain your schoolwork, even read aloud in front of the class. Feelings of embarrassment vanquished, social anxiety limited. You'll no longer be the freak sitting alone at lunch.
Eating ham and cheese on rye every day?
Excuse me?
Just how long have you been working on this normal C stuff?
Well, I suppose you could date Project Inception to our isolation of a common genetic strand, or you could go back even further to when we presupposed there was...
And did you discuss that with your wife? Over dinner. Hey, honey, guess what I isolated today? A common genetic strand.
I'm not married.
Your girlfriend?
I'm between romantic entanglements.
I'm sure you are, if you look at them as entanglements.
If I answered your question sufficiently, I'm scheduled to be elsewhere shortly.
I can see your parking space from my window. Your car is here when I go to sleep, and here when I wake up. It's always here.
I work more efficiently when others aren't present.
Just put on those headphones and fiddle on your keyboard.
Excuse me?
What did you have for lunch today?
Ham and,
Go on, say it. I know. I see the wrappers on your desk every day.
I like ham and cheese on rye.
Your big day last week. Lots of rich, old boomers handshaking and backslapping. A big celebration. Prime rib or fish? You are a no-show.
I had some work to do, so I ate in my office.
Yeah, ham and cheese on rye. Exhibits the classic symptoms of Asperger syndrome. Verbalizing internal thoughts, social awkwardness, lack of variety in diet, the ability to screen out distractions is fundamental to the subject's creativity. You know what that's from?
Obviously, it's from procedures and data from study N55469-C. I recognize
it's
the
Ben's diagnosis, written on our first day. Sound familiar?
I don't believe subjects are permitted access to that information.
Forget the study. I'm talking further back, when you were my age. Probably even further than that. Does it sound familiar?
Yes, of course it sounds familiar.
You're us. We're you. Misfits. And that's fine, I really don't mind being considered a misfit. What I mind is being treated like I'm one of God's blunders. I am not a blunder. I don't need fixed.
You're taking an extremely subjective view on what we've accomplished.
Sorry,
here.
It's the only one I've got. Don't get me wrong. I admire what you're doing. I mean, look at Eddie. That's a miracle. You made a miracle. Who can do that? But we're not
all the same. You can't just lump us into your spectrum, because Eddie's miracle is not my miracle or Ben's miracle. Look at Ben. Because of the drug making him normal, he's now joined the world and is now severely crushing on Dr. Cronus' daughter. But to get her, he needs his music. She loves music. He makes music. But if he stops taking the drug to make the music to get the girl, he'll stop crushing on the girl and go sit in the corner and make more insane music that the girl will never hear.
You're taking an extremely subjective view on what we've accomplished here.
Ben's case is not isolated. I can't draw or paint anymore. I can't see the lines and colors. And if I can't see the lines and colors, who am I?
I stand corrected. Two isolated cases.
How ignorant art thou in thy pride of wisdom?
I know that line. Have you been reading Frankenstein this entire time?
Uh-huh. I always wanted to read it. Now, thanks to you, I can. And did.
Suppose I should feel gratified.
You can see this, right? It's so us. You're Victor, you're the creator, and I'm the creature.
This appears to be my copy.
I borrowed it from your bookshelf. Do you always highlight your casual reading?
It's a favorite.
Now that's irony. You, all over a story about out-of-control science. And one written by a teenage girl. Perfect.
Ah, yes. Mary Shelley, the young romantic, championing emotion in the individual over reason and science.
Smart girl.
Naive girl. Where would we be without reason and science and creation?
You do remember that he dies in the end, right? Victor Frankenstein creates a way to give life, and then is destroyed by his creation.
Of course. But how many things are we upon the brink of discovering if cowardice or carelessness did not restrain our inquiries?
What happens if we all take the drug? Will you give us a hug? 'Cause we're finally normal. What happens if we all pop the pill? Will we all lose our will for the sake of normal? What happens to the music he plays or the art I create? Does that make us normal? What happens to the people we are, to our gifts that amaze, just to be, well, normal? No, it's not worth it. I think that you know that. Yes, I am special. I know you can see that. You can see yourself in me. There's a value in me, a value I didn't quite see. And I can't wait to be free of normal. Just like Victor Frankenstein, your creation has caught you. So you have a choice to make. Will you take it and be normal?
Where did you get that?
I've stopped taking them. I'm withdrawing from the study. So here, you can have it. What happens if now you take the drug? Will your love life improve? Will you act all normal? What happens to your sandwich on rye? Could you kiss it goodbye just to seem more normal? What happens to your daily routine? How you hide from your staff? Because, yeah, that's normal. What happens when your thoughts split in half to your curious brain? Do you think you're normal? No, it's not worth it. I think that you know that. Yes, we are special. I know you can see that. You can see yourself in us. There's a value in this, a value I didn't quite see. And I hope you can be free of normal.
What happens when we all talk the same? Will it drive us insane when we're finally normal? Sweet robots who don't challenge the rules that are set by the fools who say what is normal. What happens to the way that we think or the progress we've made now that we are normal? What happens when the strange disappears? Does the boredom set in? Oh, thank God we're normal. No, it's not worth it. I think that you know that. Yes, we're special. I know you can see that. You can see yourself in me. There's a value in me, a value I didn't quite see. And I can't wait to be free of normal.
If they could only bridge the distance. If she could only, if he could only, if they could only be more normal.
No one is normal, nothing is normal. Whoever said that anything's normal? No one is normal, nothing is normal. Whoever said that anything's normal?
Oh, I am certain of one thing. I want to be me in all of my imperfect, crazy perfection, my slightly unusual connection, my unending introspection. I know it's not your reflection,
but it's me.
It's all right here. Friends, a wife and kids, normal. All you have to do is take a little white pill. Simple, painless. But if you take it, there'll be no more scientific breakthroughs. No more miracles. Who you are now would be destroyed by the drug, your creation. Well?
Today, Eddie.
Well, what do you think, then?
Now what, Chloe?
Now that you're better.
Now that you're changing.
Now that you've given up.
I feel fine.
I don't know.
Give up?
Oh, Eddie, it's so good to hear you talk. I never thought I'd see the day, never. And now that's all I want to hear. Every word, every thought.
I love you.
Oh, Eddie, I love you too.
I'm tired of chicken.
Oh, I didn't know. It's off the menu, no more chicken.
But I like chicken.
Dad thinks the therapist is cute.
Hey!
Let's not overdo it, son.
Let's go fill this prescription.
I want a hoverboard and a Nintendo and Lego Star Wars.
Well, what do you think, Ben? Should we fill this prescription?
I guess.
What about your gift, your music?
Baby, 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 oh!
Ben, my daughter Ellie would love to hear your music.
Maybe I could just take it on the weekdays.
Not how it works, son. It has to stay in your system. You're either all in or all out, okay?
Yeah, I guess this is a pretty big deal. Maybe we should talk about it.
Over some rocky road?
Uh-huh.
So what now? Where are we gonna go? What are we gonna do with this prescription?
I love reading, Mom. I love it. I used to avoid walking past libraries and bookstores or walk blocks out of my way just to avoid feeling stupid and useless. But now I want to read everything. Books, menus, street signs.
Then why did you leave the study? You can read. It's a miracle. You're
normal.
Is that so bad?
Yes.
Okay, so I guess that's it.
That's it.
What are we gonna do now? Like, what's wrong? How about your reading?
Now that I've stopped letting myself be drugged, they said it'll take about a month or so, but I'll start seeing the lines and colors again.
I mean, what will happen with your reading? Your
disorder? It's okay. You can say it out loud. Go on.
Disorder.
Pretend you're saying normal. Only say disorder instead.
Disorder.
Like this. Disorder!
Disorder!
See, didn't that feel great?
No, not really.
I'm focusing on the positive. I can do this. I can beat this. And I can do it without the drug.
Are you sure?
No, but I'm gonna try. With your help, I think I can get my GED. I found this place in a Google search. Sounds like it might work for us. The first college in the country accredited toward bachelor degrees to students with learning disabilities.
It's in Florida? Chloe, they have alligators down there and hurricanes and humidity?
Everybody's searching for something, but does that something actually exist?
Elusive,
invisible,
evasive.
The pursuit is too hard to resist. So we chase the ghosts, we strike the pose, we try to fit in. We hide away, we shut our doors, we twist in the wind. Cause nobody knows. Yes, nobody knows. There's no normal. There's no normal. Oh no. But we look for the normal and hide all our special. Cause sometimes our special can be a real handful. And we love to pretend that everything's normal when we should agree and admit there's no normal. No.
I thought I was always so different, convinced the world was nothing like me.
Defensive,
unbearable,
secluded. I put a walls up where windows should be. I was so afraid the way I made I wouldn't fit in. But now I love that part of me, I'm fine in my skin. It's cool we both know.
Cool.
What you all should know.
There's no normal. There's no normal. Oh no. But we look for the normal and hide all our special. Cause sometimes our special can be a real handful. And we love to pretend that everything's normal when we should agree and admit there's no normal. No.
I have to sleep with two stuffed animals at night or else I can't sleep at all.
I like spoon.
I used to lick shoes.
I'm emotionally attached to a rubber duck.
I check for monsters in the shower.
I love to eat my fingernails.
I talk to myself a lot.
Oh my gosh, that's crazy.